Happiness and bacteria have one thing in common. They multiply by dividing. On behalf of the Institute's Innovation Council of Sri Nehru Mahavidyalaya College of Arts and Science, I welcome everyone to this webinar on innovative approaches in drug delivery system. Now, I call upon Mr. Dinesh, Internship Coordinator and Placement Officer, to give us the welcome note. Welcome, sir.
Yes, thank you. So there is a wonderful weather outside. So this pleasant feel in mind, let me begin the welcome speech. Greetings to one and all present here. It gives me immense warmth and great pleasure to grace all of your presence in the interest of the entire committee. It gives me tremendous contentment to be presenting the welcome speech among the most learned dignitaries connected virtually. Before we begin this session, I would like to express my heartfelt gratitude to all of you who sincerely committed to this series of sessions to make it a success. This event would have been impossible without the support of each and everyone present here. Most importantly, our respective principal sirs, support, and IAC coordinator. I'm delighted to welcome our beloved principal, Dr. B. Subramani. Sir, I welcome you. I'm excited to welcome our chief guest, Dr. Bawa Bakhruddin, Research Coordinator, Associate Professor, Sri Vidyanigetan College of Pharmacy, Tirupati, Andhra Pradesh. Sir, warm welcome to you. I'm extremely happy to extend my welcome note in welcoming the IAC coordinator, staff and student members, and also staff and student participants for the session. I express my sincere gratitude for this opportunity given to me to welcome the gathering. Once again, I welcome you all and to start the session with all positive vibes. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Now I call upon Dr. Vijay Chitra, Associate Professor, Department of Microbiology, to welcome our resource person for the day.
So a warm good afternoon to one and all present here. So it's with pleasure I take the privilege of introducing today's resource person, Dr. H. Bawa Bakhruddin. So he is a person who has a good major accomplishment and a research output. Yes, he's be a person who has got recognized and awarded by the NPDF DST CERP, and currently he is working as a research coordinator in Sri Vidyaniketan College of Pharmacy, and he is also an awardee of senior research fellowship by the CSIR, that is Council of Scientific and Industrial Research, and he has and work experience of nearly 5 years, where he has put up a major of his work in the drug designing, pharmaceuticals and other areas, and as well on personalized medicine. He has got a global exposure in that, and he has attended the conferences belonging to the research on pharmacies. and he has published international and national research papers, and he has an output of nearly 8.2 of the publications. They have an impact factor of 5.8, and he also has published books and chapters in various reputed journals and publications. So with such an eminent resource person amidst us, I do hope we'll have a good view on the drug delivery systems and the innovations that are happening in today's world. So once again, I welcome our resource person, Dr. Baba Bakrutan. Now the session is yours, sir. Thank you.
Thank you very much, ma'am. Okay. Hello,
yes,
madam.
Yes, sir. I could hear you, sir. I could hear you.
Is it audible?
Okay. Yes, sir. It's audible. Audible, sir.
Okay. My slice is visible, ma'am?
Yes, sir. It's visible. It's visible.
Okay.
So it's perfectly, everything is perfect, sir.
Okay. Shall I start now?
Yes, sir. You can start.
Okay.
If you want, sir, if you want, you can switch on your video. If you are...
Okay. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. 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 Good morning to all. I want to thank the Kare Nehru Mahavidyalaya College of Arts and Science for presenting this topic, the innovative approaches in drug delivery system. Very much thank to the faculties and the students who are working in the college. So before going to the topic, I want to say about some introductions about drug delivery systems. So before going for the innovative approaches, we'll small discussion about the drug delivery systems. So drug delivery system is defined as a formulation or a device that enables the introduction of therapeutic substance in the body and improve its efficacy and safety. Because the improve its efficacy and safety by controlling the rate, time and place where we have to release the drug. So the targeting place is important in the body. So if you're going for the any drug delivery system, you have to know about that. Causing and the efficacy and safety. Efficacy and safety is very major role, because the patient care is very, very much important before going for the any medicaments to the patients. So the efficacy and the safety is very much a concern if you are developing any drug delivery system. And also the controlling of rate, how much amount of medicaments you want to deliver in the time manner, and also where you want to release the drug, that is place of release of drug in the body. So this is small introduction about the drug delivery system. So then we'll go for the what is a drug delivery system comprises. What it is? It is one type of drug formulation, and also if it is one type of medical device or dosage form, a technology to carry the drug inside the body. So and also it has own mechanisms for releasing order. For example, it's like a sustained release or controlled release. It may be a controlled sustained release, and also the time programmed release. So the mechanism is important for the development of drug delivery system. So it has some limitations over the conventional drug delivery system. That is required higher doses in the conventional drug delivery system. So we can use limited dose in the drug delivery system and the low effectiveness, because the conventional drug delivery system, the conventional delivery system having low effectiveness, but we can achieve in this drug delivery system. That means advanced drug delivery systems. And toxicity is major role for the conventional medicaments, and adverse event also one type of limitations. So the ideal properties of material for drug delivery, if you are going for the preparation of a drug delivery system, the material, the base material or carrier should be some idealistic properties. It should be a structural control over size and shape. So the size and shape is very important while developing any drug delivery system, because based upon that size and shape, we can accommodate our medicament in that polymeric, in that carrier. And also second one is, it should be a biocompatible and non-toxic polymer functionality. So we know very well about it should be a biocompatible, and it is non-toxic polymeric functionality. Polymeric functionality in the sense, it should be some modifiable properties. And also, it should be a precise and nanoscale container or scaffolding properties with a high drug or imaging agent capacity features. So if you are preparing any novel drug delivery system, the size range, the nanoscale size range is precise, and it should be some scaffolding material. It's like a biomaterial property, holding capacity of more drugs and releasing capacity of longer duration. So that is very much important when going for the preparation of drug delivery system. And it should be a well-defined scaffolding. Already the utilized scaffold is very much useful for developing further advancement. And surface modifiable functionality. So we have to modify our carrier based upon that the release order will be changed, so that it should be in surface modifiable functionality for cell specific targeting moiety. Based upon the targeting, it should be some surface modifiable functionality. And we know that lack of immunogenicity, it should not produce any immunogenicity to the biological system. And appropriate cellular adhesion. So the cellular adhesion is very important, because if you are releasing drug to the certain target area, the cell adhesion is main role. And endocytotoxicity, because it should not produce any toxicity on that cell, it will be removed from that cell after releasing the drug at the site of action. And the intracellular trafficking, so it should be cross over the cell to cell. There is no interconvergence between two cells. It will cross over that. That means it should be with allow therapeutic delivery or imaging in the cytoplasm nucleus. And also it should be acceptable bioelimination and biodegradation. So we know that the biodegradation, biodegradation is very important for development of a drug delivery system. After releasing the drug, it should be eliminated from the biological system, or it should degrade in that system itself. And controlled release or triggerable drug release. It should the material should be a controlled release, or otherwise triggering factor triggering factor for the release of drugs, and it should be a molecular level isolation and production of a drug against inactivation during transit to target cells, and it should minimum non-specific cellular and blood protein binding properties. Blood protein binding properties is very important so that we can achieve more plasma concentration in the bacterial system. So EC constant and reproducibility, it should be clinical grade material. Okay, so that this is the main ideal property while going for the advanced drug delivery system. So what is the aim of drug delivery system? So before, the aim is to improving efficacy and safety of the medicine as well as commercial pharmaceutical development. Some important point is improvement of drug safety and efficacy, and improved compliance and chronopharmacological benefits, that is good efficacy will give good efficacy. So the reduction of cost of drug development. So the cost reduction is very, very important for the development of advanced drug delivery system. And the life extension of the products, so it should be more stable through the entire drug development and in the marketing period. So it should be the drug delivery system having more extension of the product, life extension of the product will give more attraction to the society. And the reduction of risk of failure in new product development. So we have to very much consideration about risk of failure, reduction of risk of failure in development of new products. So next one is characteristics of an ideal drug delivery system. So the characteristics means the ideal drug delivery system, it should increase the bioavailability of drug, it should provide the controlled drug delivery, it should transport the drug intact to the site of action while avoiding the non-diseased host tissues, and the product should be stable and deliver should be maintained under various physiological variables means the pH or temperature. Okay, so the high degree of drug dispersion in the biological system, and also the ideal drug delivery system, the same method should be applicable to a wide range of drugs. So if you want to any other drug, for any of the drug, it should be affordable to deliver the drug at the site of action. So it should be easy to administer to the patients. It should be safe and reliable. It should be cost effective. So the classifications of drug delivery system that affect the release and the bioavailability. Based upon the release and the bioavailability of drugs, we can classify. So if it is released in the systemic region or localized region, we can say systemic drug delivery and the localized drug delivery, and general non-targeted delivery to all tissues. It will administer through the oral cavity. So through the cavity, it will release a certain period, and it will excreted through the fecal matters. So that is general non-targeted delivery to all tissues, and targeted delivery to a system or organ. So we have to target the system or organ. That is one type of classification. And the controlled risk delivery system, that is systemic delivery, mainly for the systemic delivery, and the release on time scale, that is immediate release. This is one type of fast release, and programmed release, the time being based upon the time period, it will release the drug, the medicaments to the biological system. So that is one type of classification. Mm-hmm. And delayed and sustained prolonged release for the long acting purpose. So if you want to release the drug throughout the month or after the month, after the 6 months, if you want, you can deliver, you can release the drug, these type of classifications. And targeted release, the targeted release means it's one type of targeting to the organs or tissues or any systems, any biological systems. And site-specific controlled release following delivery to a target organ. This is one type of drug delivery system, site-specific. So based upon the site-specific, it specifically will release on that organ tissue or cells, and release in response to requirements or feedbacks. Based upon the requirements and feedback, it will release. That is controllable by using some other external factors, it will release. And receptor-mediated targeted drug delivery. So based upon the receptor targeting, it will release the drug at the site of action. And type of drug delivery, drug delivery devices. That is one type of drug delivery system. So these are the drug delivery system, based upon the route of administration. So nasal drug delivery through the nasal drafts, and pulmonary delivery in the form of inhalers, and the transdermal delivery through the patches, and also parenteral delivery through different routes, and oral delivery through the oral cavity, and it will reach the intestinal site, and ocular delivery through the ocular site by lens, contact lens. So the classification of various anatomical routes of systemic drug delivery, one is gastrointestinal system, that is oral drug delivery, that is what all the medicaments, all the formulations will administer to the system, biological system. It will release wherever you want, that is. And also the rectal delivery, we have to administer to the rectal region. It will release the drug at the site of action. So another one part, this is very important for advances in drug delivery system. Physicochemical factors in gastrointestinal tract that influence oral drug delivery system. Starting from stomach, it will change the pH from 1.5 to 6.67. So based upon that, we can deliver the drug. We can target the site to deliver the drugs. And the transit time, based upon the transit time, we can design the drug delivery system and mucus layers based. We can target the drug delivery system and microbes. Based upon the microbes available in our biological system, we can target. So another one part is a transdermal drug delivery system. It's a transmucosal delivery. That is through mucosal lining the rest of gastrointestinal tract. And another one type is buccal and sublingual route. In the region of sublingual, under the tongue, we can deliver the drug. And the buccal route under the lips, we can deliver the drug. Nasal route and rectal route is one type of transdermal delivery patches. Then physical enhancement methods for transdermal delivery of drugs. Some of the physical enhancement methods like micro needles and ionophoresis through some electrical stimulus, and the thermal ablations through some thermal devices, and the velocity based device through the injections, jet injections, And sonophoresis is one type of delivery instrument through the skin. So another one is a transnasal drug delivery through the nasal cavity. We have to deliver by using some inhalers and that is by using some drafts, nasal drafts, and also pulmonary delivery through drug delivery by inhalations and intraosseous infusions. It will deliver the drug inside the bone marrow, osseous sites. Then another one classification is parenteral drug delivery system. This is one part of drug delivery system. So based upon the administration site, we can deliver the drug. So for example, if you want to deliver the drug in the subcutaneous region, you have to administer the drug or place the drug in the form of implants. We can place the drug on the place of subcutaneous. It will release the drug prolong the time. So like that, the advanced parenteral drug delivery system classified in further three classifications. That is one type of injection model, and another one is implant model and the infusion devices. So infusion devices, one by one we can see in the later. Then parenteral drug delivery having some advantages. Because it's rapid onset action, because it is almost complete viability it will give, and it is predictable, and the avoidance of gastrointestinal tract with the problem of oral administration. So provides a reliable route of drug administration in very ill and comatose patients who are not able to ingest anything orally. So these are the small advantages for a parenteral drug delivery system. Some drawback is there in the parenteral drug delivery system. That is, injection is not an ideal method for delivery because pain involved. So the patient complaint will be more. So the injection have limitations for delivery of proteins, particularly those that require sustained level. So these are the some smaller drawbacks for the preparation of for the product of parenteral drug delivery system. So another one is the nanomedicine for cardiovascular drug delivery application. So these are the different nanomaterials that is used for the application of cardiovascular site. That is, for example, for the clot in the heart wall, by using nanoparticles, it will release the clot by using some unique modification of modified nanoparticles, and the stent nanoparticles coated drug eluting stent is one type of drug delivery and cardiovascular drug delivery material. So another one is drug delivery to the CNS. So it is three major subdivisions. One is invasive techniques. It is through the surgery only we can do this type of delivery. And non-invasive method is a chemical and biological products based upon the formulation. We have to administer through the different route. It will deliver the drug at the site of CNS area. So based upon that, we can classify. And another one is miscellaneous techniques. That is intranasal delivery and ionotropic delivery. This is one type of electroimpulsive deliveries. So the conclusions, remarks on route of drug delivery. These are the different routes of administration. Some issues will be there. It is listed here. That is delivery to blood circulation. So depends upon the route. We can say the delivery of material to the blood circulation. For example, the delivery of indirect through GI tract for the oral drug delivery system, and onset of action is slow, and bioavailability is low to high. Initially it will low and it will go to the high. Dose control is moderate, and administration, self-administration we can provide for the oral drug delivery system. Patient convenience is high, and the adverse effect is GI upset. Sometimes it will produce some adverse effect. Use of proteins and peptides, no, there is no proteins and peptides using through this oral intestinal based drug delivery system. So like that, the depends upon the route of administration, some issues will be there. I have listed here. So it's the novel part, that is novel carriers and formulation for drug delivery, that is novel preparations for improving bioavailability of drugs, mainly the criteria for innovative formulations. So the criteria means oral drug delivery system having fast dissolving tablets and technology to increase gastrointestinal retention time, technology to improve drug release mechanisms of oral preparations, adjuvants to enhance absorption. So these are the some criteria for development of any novel drug delivery system. And another one is method of increasing bioavailability of drugs. That is, you have to choose the penetration enhancer, penetration enhancer for the achievement of bioavailability, and improve the dissolution rate by using some other polymers or some other polymers, and also biological material or natural materials, and inhibition of degradation prior to reaching site of actions. So these are the method of increasing bioavailability of drugs, and production of therapeutic substance inside the body, that is gene therapy and cell therapy. These are the novel preparations for improving bioavailability of drugs. So then the novel carrier material for drug delivery, these are the some materials nowadays we are using in the research sector. One is the polymer carrier for drug delivery, and collagen is a very good biological material for development of drug delivery system, and particulate drug delivery system like a microsphere or a liposomes or nanosphere, that is coming in this drug delivery system, that is particulate drug delivery system. And nanobiotechnology based methods including nanoparticles such as liposomes and glass like sugar matrices, resealed RBC antibody integrated systems. So these are the novel carriers. Nowadays the research going on, and some more product has launched into the approved, got approved from the FDA and launched to the market. Just I want to introduce them. And biodegradable implants for controlled sustained drug release. So injectable implants, that is in the form of gels and microspheres, and surgical implants in the form of sheets, films and foams, scaffolds. So these are the biodegradable implants. It will release the drug at the site of action in the controlled sustained drug delivery manner. So the we'll go for the innovation for improving oral drug delivery system. This is one type of innovation nowadays going on, that is soft gels. Soft gel is already, we know that soft gel, we know you put soft gel preparations, soft gel products, like a gelling shell and filled with medicaments. So it will give a good option to the patients. Another one is fast dissolving tablet. So in that phosphorus dissolving tablet, we have to segregate the particles and assemble like this manner, the one type of conceptional, one second type of that means the linear linear manner. So the medicaments, so the drug will release easily. That is that is once one row of drugs and fast dissolving granules will be in the another adjacent side, and disintegrating agents will be in the another side. So the drug easily dissolve in the medium, dissolve in the biological medium, and the immediate effect will go. So the achievement of plasma concentration and the bioavailability will be more. So mechanism of controlled release of drugs using different types of nanocarriers. So nanocarriers mechanism, one is a diffusion model. The drug will be released through the diffusion diffusion from the carrier, and the solvent model. If you are giving stimulus from the solvent, the solvent itself giving stimulus to the particles, it will release the drug. And the stimuli sensitive, so through the magnetism or light, it will release the drug. And through the chemical reactions, through the enzyme hydrolysis at pH, it will release the drug. So this is a mechanism of controlled release of drugs. So another one big innovative part is drug delivery devices. So classification of drug delivery devices based upon the surgically implanted devices for prolonged sustained drug release, that is drug reservoirs. And another one part is pump and conduct. We'll see in the next slides one by one. So the drug delivery devices, this manner. For example, if you are taking the needle injection, the drug will be directly coming to the systemic circulation through the injection. And jetting is one type of drug delivery. You have to administer through the hose. And another one is hydrophoresis. The stimulus will be given by some electrical impulse. The drug will be released in the through the patches. And ultrasound, applying ultrasound, it will release the drug. And the hyperthermia is one type of heat. Through the heat, it will release the drug from the patch. And magnetic delivery, the drug and carrier will be in the circulation. The magnetic trace, through the trace, the carrier and medicament will be located in the site and release the drug at the site of action. So another one part is convection. Through the convection stimulus, the drug will be released in the systemic circulation. So these are the targeted drug delivery strategies with a drug loading percentage. So if you are taking drug crystals and nanocrystals aggregates, up to you can achieve 90% drug loading in that on that carrier. Liposomes, if you are 62%, up to 62% of drug you can load in the liposomes. In the 50% drug loading we can achieve in the polymeric micelles, and 90% drug will be combined with the protein based nanoparticles. And the same like that, dentine is 50%, we can achieve the drug loading. And the silica nanoparticles, 40% we can achieve the drug loading. And the 75% of drug loading we can achieve in the polymer drug conjugates. So the drug loading is very important role for the development of drug delivery system, because achievement of drug loading property in the carrier, the carrier will be more effort to pass the it will pass the other type of advantages, and also it will reach very fast to the marketing approval and the marketing commercialization of the products is very important. Commercialization of the product will be more attractive if you have more than 90% recording capacity with the material. And also implantable biosensor and drug delivery system, that is one type of pump will be in the chest side, so the controlling system is in the outside of the body. You have to trigger the pump, the drug will be released to your blood circulation. So the sensor will be implanted in your another place of your body. So the sensor will indicate this much drug has released in your body, so that the sensor instruction given to the control system. The control system will control the drug pump. So like this manner, the process will go. This type of implantable biosensor drug delivery system. And also another one part is a drug delivery and the diagnostic using microfluidics. So for example, one type of micro needles deliver the drug, deliver the insulin or drugs into the body. It's like a patches with a small needle shape impregnated with the medications. So control release microchips. This is one advancement and innovative products. Nowadays, it is in the observation stage. Another one, that is microchip, control release microchip. It has chip contains drug doses, electronics that support chip functions and batteries, titanium base. So ceramic or titanium base as a substrate, and drug will be in the cone shaped space, and anode reservoir cap will be in the top. So based upon the circuit command, the drug will be released. And the sensor will be control the release. So this is one type of drug delivery system. Nowadays, they are coming in the clinical trials. So the pumps and the conduit for drug delivery system. This is one type of conduit delivery system. That is magnetic block will be there, and also aperture, that membrane will be there. So the drug will be in the lower side. Based upon the triggering factor, the drug will be released through this area. So the triggering factor may be the magnetic field or electric field. The drug will be released through the membrane. So this is one type of osmotic micro pump for drug delivery. So based upon the osmotic pressure, our body, it may be controlled by our body temperature or an external factor. It will release the drug through this needle, and it will go to the site of action. So this is one type of drug delivery system. And these are the some nanomaterials and biotechnologies used for the drug delivery system. So current trends in pharmaceutical products development. So what are the current trends we are using? That is use of recombinant DNA technology, the expansion of use of protein and peptide drugs in current therapeutics. So protein and peptide drug in current therapeutics nowadays playing very big role in the development of drug delivery system. Introduction of antisense, RNA interference and gene therapy, and advances in cell therapy, introduction of stem cells. So stem cells nowadays giving big advantage to development of a drug delivery system. Based upon that stem cell, we can eliminate the forthcoming disease also. and miniaturization of drug delivery through the microparticle and nanoparticles. Okay, then increasing use of bioinformatics and computer drug designing, and a trend towards development of target organ oriented dosage form, increasing emphasis on controlled release drug delivery, use of routes of administration other than injections. So increasing alliance between pharmaceutical companies and the drug delivery system companies. So nowadays the pharmaceutical companies upgrading to the drug delivery companies, because the lots of drug delivery material, drug delivery product is coming into the market. So they are going to prepare, they are getting ready to prepare that formulations. So this is interrelationship of drug delivery system and pharmaceutical industry and biotechnology. So drug delivery system, lots of interrelations with the pharmaceutical company and biotechnological industry. So new drug delivery systems, gene therapy and stem cells therapy and nanobiotechnology, all are coming into the in the part of new drug delivery technologies. So these are the small collaborative scheme for interrelation between pharmaceutical industry and biotechnological industry. So the for expansion of pharmaceutical industry to new markets. So nowadays they are converting the drug delivery companies. They are increasing the markets to the nowadays they are increasing the market in the society, so that the new product is coming and developing the marketing strategy itself. So currently we have personalized medicine. So the preventions, diagnosis and treatment. So these three important factors is very much role in the personalized medicine. So currently we are yearly detection of patients at risk, improve preventive measures. So based upon that, we can identify what are the risk factors we have. So based upon that, we'll prevent from that that problem or disease or disorders. And diagnostics, so we are doing individual diagnosis for a whole body. For example, the whole body, that means whole body diagnosis, so that we can judge our health profile. So this will be one type of personalized medicines. And also treatment. So the treatment wise, improve outcomes through targeted treatments and reduce the side effects. So it will reduce the side effects. If you know about the diagnostic properties, you can reduce the side effects. So these are the some industry, drug delivery system industry still facing challenges. That is drug delivery technologies require constant redesigning to keep up with the new methods of drug design and manufacturing, particularly of biotechnology products. So constantly they are redesigning with their products based upon that the innovative approach of the product. So the manufacturing methods and manufacturing the place and building, everything should be some other advancement technology they need. So they are facing these type of challenges, especially in the biotechnology product development. As a cost of drug are rising, and drug delivery aims to reduce the cost by improving the bioavailability of drug, so that lesser quantities need to be taken in by the patients. So the cost is very effective, very effective in the advancement of drug delivery system. So the we have to consider about reducing the cost, then only the challenges will be fulfilled. And more fundamental research needs to be done, because the fundamental research is going on, still now is going on. So that the fundamental research is very important to break some barriers, like some physiological barriers related information we need for the development of brain related disease and disorders, and also new materials that are being dissolved, such as nanoparticles, need to have safety studies and regulatory approvals. So nowadays the nanoparticles having in the streamline of safety studies and regulatory approvals, so that we can expect more new materials in the forthcoming era. We are expecting more new materials like nanoparticles. So some of the new innovative drug delivery system I mentioned here, in 2011 it is it has published some more innovative drug delivery system, that is EVAX therapeutic exosome, and also another one is Inovia smart vaccine delivery. It's a COVID-19 potential game changer for COVID-19 pandemic. It will release the vaccine. To warm the body, that is immune system, to drive the immune response. So that directly it will trigger the immune response. So this is one type of smart vaccine delivery, and closed loop insulin delivery. This is already it's not a new innovation, which is already there, but nowadays they modified the system. That is because that is one type of slim X2 insulin pump and controlled IQ advanced hybrid closed loop technology to control type 1 diabetes. So based upon the data, it is available in our mobile phone and some other that means the outside controlling unit. Based upon that, we can regulate our body for the delivery of insulin. So this is one type of closed loop insulin delivery. So now they are going to the market. And another one is enabled injections drug delivery patch. That is one type of enabled injections. That is subcutaneous drug delivery platform with the infuse, which works as on the body patch. The platform is designed for control subcutaneous administration of large volume. That ranges from 5 ml to 50 ml. So 5 ml to 50 ml, we can store the medicament and release through the patch by using this small needle injections. And Teva digital inhaler. This is one type of digital inhaler. For controlling the symptoms of asthma and preventing woozings in the age between 12 and above, so it will much more useful for the application of asthma patient and that means long term wheezing patients, chronic wheezing patients. And another one is John Hopkins micro device. This is one type of theragrippers. Theragrippers means it's a dust specific sized micro device made up of thin shape changing film and coated with heat sensitive paraffin wax, can potentially carry any drug and release it gradually into the body, and the thoracics deploy the drug in the gastrointestinal tract, and the drug will be released at certain period, and then the micro device will be excreted through the gastrointestinal muscular junctions. So this is one type of LIRA therapeutics bioabsorbable treatment. That is one type of bio reabsorbable treatment, and that is the bio reabsorbable matrix, polymeric matrix using here for the application of otolaryngeal disease treatment. So this is very much useful for the patient to treat chronic rhinosinusitis. It will release the medicament so long time, up to 6 months. So these are the natural products based nanotechnology and drug delivery. Some other the natural polymers using for the drug delivery application. So like starch, cellulose, carbon. So nowadays the researchers are taking natural product as a drug delivery carrier, and microorganism also they are using for the drug delivery carriers. And some of the examples of the natural compounds extracted from higher plants using for nanomedicine. So lots of natural compounds they are extracting for the purpose of antimicrobial application, anti-inflammatory, antioxidants, anti-cancer, cardiovascular protection. That lots of application they are doing in the natural medicines, natural plants. So these are the list of polymeric nanoparticles. Some of the examples on the list. So that is approved by the FDA. So by types of carrier and materials, some of the carriers I have mentioned here for the application of the delivery system. So that's all. Thank you very much for the for all for observing my presentations. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. It was a wonderful presentation.
Yes.
Thank you, sir, for the information packed session. I'm sure it taught a whole lot of people something new. So does anyone have any questions? Students can unmute or they can leave their questions in the chat box below. Last but definitely not the least, I welcome Ms. Esther Rani from 3rd BSc Microbiology to give us the vote. Welcome.
Esther, will you stop presenting the screen?
Hello?
Will you stop presenting the screen?
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay.
Good evening. morning, everyone. I extend my sincere gratitude to our guest speaker, Dr. H. Baba Bakruddin, for enlightening and education as one of the innovative approaches of drug delivery system. Second, I thank our beloved principal, Dr. Subramani, for being a support towards the growth of SNM ECAS and its students. I would also like to thank our convener, Dr. Vijay Chitra, Associate Professor, Department of Microbiology. Along with this, I would also thank Mr. Dinesh, Placement Officer and Internship Coordinator, for this beautiful welcoming. Last but not the least, I thank Ms. Prashiva, ISA student member, and all the participants who made this webinar a success. Thank you all. So thank you, sir.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you to all the students and faculties.
Your presentation was very nice, sir. You had a very good presentation, sir.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you.